And when I watch Tremaine Edmonds, when you watch him, he's not afraid to stick his nose in there. He attacks the ball. He attacks the ball carrier. He doesn't wait for action. He goes and creates action. So that's what gets me excited first. He doesn't mind the contact. Second of all, I mean, I love that size. 6'4", 250, linebacker. You can't teach that size. And then you got him, and he's only 19 years old. And if you look at his career at Virginia Tech, each year he got better and better. He didn't taper off. And this last year, he went off and exploded. So that's what gives me excitement when I got a young kid with great size, and each year he gets better and better. And whenever he played a tough team, he always showed up. So that's why I want a guy like that. You can stick him with the Jalen Smith and then a Sean Lee and add another linebacker. Then I feel a little bit better about a linebacker and Cohen Gore and Ford.
Hey, I got Derwin Trinidad James. You go out there and you get that guy, man. I'm telling you, I'm a defensive guy. You know, I love defense, you know. So I'm looking at it from the aspect. You go out and you grab Derwin James, you know for sure you don't have to worry at all with your secondary. You don't have to worry at all. You got Chris Richards out there. You understand that, okay, maybe you can find some other pieces that can put together as far as their front four. But now you don't have to worry about nothing. Your secondary from your cornerback outlook of things, all the way through your safety is good. You got every piece that you need out there. And then if you go in the second round and you get an Isaiah Wynn, maybe you can figure out a way to get an Isaiah Wynn. He can just be as serviceable. And one can argue and say, hell, he's better than Hernandez. One, there could be another debate somewhere else. But hey, you get him, that'll be Zeke's toy. You're going to have Ezekiel Elliott averaging what? 5, 6, 7, 8 yards a carry. Not 8 yards. I'm just being crazy on that one. But yeah, he said all type of records. But you're going to have, if you have a better running game out of Ezekiel Elliott, that's better defense. And we was number 8th overall collectively in defense last year. Now, if you got Isaiah Wynn, now you're talking about sliding that number, because now you're going to be able to run a better offense as far as keeping Dak Prescott upright. Ezekiel Elliott's going to pound the rock, get more yards. We're going to have a better goal line, money zone, money type of threat out there on when you get towards the end zone. So now you have all those pieces added together. Man, you're talking about, I guarantee you, without even looking at the schedule, I guarantee you a top 5 defense. Defense win championships. That's just my thoughts.
For the sake of throwing a different answer, for the sake of a different answer, since both you guys swiped my answers. Don't worry. I knew I should have let off. Dang it.
You know you should have let off.
And yet I kicked it to you. For the sake of a different answer, I'm going to say I'd like to see an impactful defensive tackle. I don't think Dallas values that position as a first-round grade, but a guy like Vita Vea or Darren Payne out of Alabama would be another one I'd be interested in seeing. I want to see a, you know, big presence in the middle, a run stopper, a guy who can still put a little bit of pressure on the quarterback. And I think that's something we haven't really had with Rod Marinelli's defense in Dallas. We've had guys that flashed, you know, like Irving has kind of done that at times when he's been put in that position. But beyond that, I just think that's a big thing that we need. And that's a critical part of the kind of defense we run. So.